Last bitch, give a fuck about a nigga. Big Birkin bag, hold 5-6 figures. Stripes on my ass, so he call his pussy Tigger. Fucking on a scamming ass, rich ass nigga.
Same group of bitches, ain't no ass to the picture. Drop a couple rights, watch his ass get thicker. Drinking, I'm licking, I'm licking at your nigga.
What the fuck is up, YouTube? And we're back with my fourth video. And I'm actually excited. Because I got a lot of stuff planned for YouTube, and it's going to be a long journey. So with that being said, if you guys can like, comment, and subscribe, yes, it means a lot to me. I promise you, y'all don't know how much it means. I'm actually gaining subscribers like every day, views every day. I'm just like, okay, we're slowly moving up, slowly but surely, and yes. This video is going to be about reading assumptions about me, which I'm kind of pressed because, y'all know, I don't take criticism or whatever stuff. Whatever y'all got to say, I really don't care. But, I'm just playing. But, yeah, y'all know the routine. I ask my Instagram followers, Facebook, friends, everybody, to be honest, to give me some assumptions about me. What y'all gotta think about me? But yeah, with that being said, let's get into this video. Either way, so the first assumption about me is that I am stuck up or bougie. And I really don't think I'm stuck up. I don't know if stuck up and bougie is in the same category, but I don't think I'm stuck up, or I really don't think I'm bougie. I'm more bougietto. I'm bougie, low-key ghetto. Bougietto. I'm bougietto. I really feel like I deserve... that do kind of sound bougie, but I really feel like I deserve... the expensive things in life are not expensive things, but I think I deserve better. I feel like I deserve better things in life. And I feel like I carry myself with that mentality. So my mom always basically taught me, no matter what situation you're going through, whatever you're going through, don't let people know don't carry yourself that way, I'm guessing. So I always carry myself, I always like to look cute, look up to date, whatever the case may be. So if that makes me bougie, well, I guess I'm fucking bougie, I don't give a fuck. But yeah, the second assumption about me is that I always look angry. I always look angry at something or everyone, everything, I guess. I just really have like a resting bitch face when I'm like not talking to you or not speaking in general. I just actually look like, I don't know, I probably get that from my mom because she's literally the resting bitch face queen. She's always looking mad, so I think that's where I got it from, but I promise you, I'm not mad. I'm always happy. I'm always giving you positive vibes, to be honest. I'm trying to, but yeah, I always get positive vibes or positive aura around me. Yep. The next thing on the list of assumptions about me, low-key got me pressed, but I'm not even gonna trip on it, is that I'm judgmental. And I really don't feel like I'm judgmental. First of all, I'm gay as fuck. I didn't know gay people could be judgmental. I mean, yeah, the gays are judgmental as fuck. But I really don't feel like I'm judgmental. I let anybody do what you want to do. Do what pleases you and do it right. Basically, who cares about what everybody thinks or what anybody thinks? But I'm really not judgmental. If I am, I try not to be, but I just really be blunt. So I'm really not judgmental, but yeah, that low-key breaks me. The next assumption about me is that I'm really outgoing and a people person. Y'all, this is so crazy because I don't think I was outgoing or a people person until I got to college or, well, no, high school maybe. Because I just talk to everybody. Like, I compliment everybody. I just feel like, just talk to people. That's why my major was sociology, because I like people, but I switched it. But yeah, I'm really am outgoing and I'm really am a people person. I really just, I don't know, I like talking to people and seeing what people are about, you know? The next thing on the assumptions about me is that I party a lot. And I really don't feel like I party a lot. I mean, I did. I mean, I slowed down. I really slowed down on partying and doing all the extra stuff. So I really don't party as much. But back then, if this was an assumption about me, you would be freaking correct, because I did used to party a lot. But the next assumption about me is that I am mixed. And I am mixed with Black and Native American. I'm mixed with I'm mixed with two different Native American tribes. Sorry, I don't want y'all scalping me. And they are, my dad is, on my dad's side, I think it was Cherokee. And then my mom's side was Chickasaw. Yeah, I think so, yeah. So I'm mixed with Black and Indian, Native American. Yeah. The next assumption about me was that I'm an alcoholic. And I really don't think I'm an alcoholic, because I've been drinking since I was 16. I'm just lit. But I'm really not an alcoholic. I like to drink. I don't like to drink where it gets me fucked up and unresponsive like some of you. But no, I do like to drink. I like to drink wine. I like to drink my little hard liquor whenever I'm just out with my bitches. I guess I am low-key alcoholic. When I turn 21, it's over. I'm drinking in the daytime, nighttime, evening time, morning. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. I'm going to be drinking. Yes. The next assumption about me is that I like older guys. And I really don't like older guys back then. But now I actually do like older guys. Older guys are great. They are kind of different from the younger guys, but I do like older guys now, because my last relationship, or whatever the case may be, whatever that we want to call that, I was actually messing with a younger person, and that was the worst. It was so terrible. It wasn't all bad, but it was terrible. So I'm sticking to my older guys now. So, with that being said, if you ordered in 20, DM me. Period.
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 Period. Period.
The next assumption about me is that my family is rich. And no, my family is not rich. We take care of ourselves. I mean, I really don't know how to, we're not rich though. We all work around there. We all basically get it how we live. That's the only way I could basically put that. The next assumption about me is that I'm not from here, which is Oklahoma. I am from here, sadly. I am born and raised in Oklahoma. I know, it may seem like I'm from a different state, maybe because, I don't know, I'm always everywhere. But yeah, I am from Oklahoma, sadly, and yeah. And 2 more years until I bounce out of here, and with that being said, we're just gonna cut it right there. Next assumption about me is that I like drama. Back in my high school days, when I was a messy gay ass bitch, yes, I used to love drama. I used to like it. I used to love it, entertain it, do whatever I need to do to be a part of it. But now I am not like that. I don't like drama. I don't like people in drama. I don't like my friends in drama. I don't like being around near drama. I don't like it. I don't like nothing. No. I like to stay away from it. I like to keep my distance. I like to just chill. So yeah, I don't like drama. Don't really mess with it. The next assumption about me is that I have a lot of friends. And I did have a lot of friends. I had to cut a lot of my friends off for personal reasons and for my own reasons and personal growth, actually. But I do talk to a lot of people. I do make connections with a lot of people. I wouldn't say they're friends, more like acquaintances. And like, you know, people at my school, I really talk to them. So, I mean, you can call people at my school friends, I guess. But I do have a lot of people I talk to and like associate with and hang out with. And that will conclude my YouTube video about reading assumptions about me. Thank you for basically giving me the assumptions about me again. Thank you for watching my YouTube videos. Thank you for liking. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for commenting. I promise I will comment on every comment that I get. My links will be down in the description for my social medias, Facebook, Snap, Twitter, Instagram. I will be editing this video as soon as possible so I can keep bringing content to you guys. And with that being said, continue to be a boss ass bitch and don't do anything I wouldn't do. And I'll see you guys later.
Hey yo, been a bad bitch, Kakiana. And I'm still winning Pacquiana. Percocets, Papiana, killing everybody beat. Thank you, Max, Ariana.